Hi and welcome to this week's web design video blog. Today we're going to continue our three-part series on sIFR font replacement.
For part two, we've prepared a walkthrough tutorial for installing sIFR on your website.
So I've created a simple HTML page which I've uploaded onto the Creair blog. It's important to also understand that you can't actually get sIFR to work locally if you're creating websites from your desktop. So the sIFR walkthrough folder here holds this page and its files, and I'm uploading this onto the Creair blog. I've also downloaded the latest copy of sIFR 3 from the internet. So first of all, if we open up the sIFR 3 folder once we've downloaded it, and there's only a few files from here that we actually need in order to get sIFR to work on our website. So if I open up our webpage HTML files, first thing I need from the sIFR folder is the CSS. So if I take sIFR CSS and copy that into my CSS folder, and then the only other folder I need is the JavaScript folder, which has various JavaScripts in. I haven't got a JS folder, so I'll just take the entire folder and add that to my web page. So now that I've done that, in Dreamweaver we have all the files that we need with the exception of the typeface to get sIFR working. So next we need to create the SWIFT for our typeface HipChick. So if we go back to the sIFR 3 folder and go into the Flash folder and open up sIFR.fla, and make sure you have the selection tool selected, double click the empty white box and you'll see that the text has appeared. Next, just choose the type selection tool and highlight all of the text inside this box. Now you'll probably find if you read the instructions that you can actually embed various weights like bold, italic and normal, but I just like to do one at a time because I don't really like to use sIFR for anything other than headings. So if I type out a short word like HipChick for example, and then I'm going to change this typeface using the text properties into my typeface called HipChick, so let's just find that. Like so. And then all I need to do is push character embedding, which is also under the text properties. And then I'm going to embed uppercase, lowercase, the numerals and punctuation. So obviously if you do need more, you can select those. I'll push OK. Now I'll go to File, Publish Settings. I don't need the HTML file. And then if I choose the destination, we'll also rename this to HipChick. And if I choose the destination to put this, so we'll choose the sIFR walkthrough on our desktop. We'll put it on the root layer. And then if we go to the Flash settings, because this is a pre-made FLA file, all the settings are correct for sIFR, so Flash Player 8, Protect from Import and Emit Trace Actions, and we can press Publish. So that's our typeface SWIFT published. And again, if we go back to Dreamweaver, we'll see that we have our HipChick typeface now ready to use. So now that we have all the files that we need, the CSS, the JavaScript and the typeface, let's join all the dots together and enable sIFR on our web page. Firstly, let's just upload the CSS, the JavaScript and the typeface. And then while that's uploading, let's open up our index or template page. And the first thing that we need to run is the sIFR CSS. So let's just drag that across. We then need to run two JavaScripts from the JavaScript folder. So I'm just pasting in empty JavaScript tags just to save time. So let's just drop that JavaScript folder down, and the first one we need to run, and it's important to run these in the correct order, is sIFR.js, and the second one is sIFR.config. So that's all we need to do to our template or homepage. Let's upload that to the server and we can close that down. All we need to do next is customize our sIFR config file. So the first thing we need to do is just change Futura, which is the default typeface, to the name of our typeface. We then set the path, so our hipchick.swift is on the root layer. Then we have to activate sIFR, so we just change Futura again to hipchick. And then finally, one last time at the bottom by the selector. So what this selector is going to do, which we'll go into more detail on our next video blog, is change the heading ones to HipChick using sIFR. So first of all, let's change the typeface colour to a dark grey. Now, because it's going to be put out as Flash, we don't want the background colour. But simply taking this away isn't enough. We also need to use the Flash window mode transparent. We'll go into a little bit more detail about tuning tips, like I said, next week. And one final thing we'll do is just align the text to the centre. So that's all the customising that we need to do to this file at the moment. I've taken away the background and made it transparent, aligned the text to the centre, and changed the colour. So now we can upload this file. And now hopefully when we refresh our web page, the heading 1 will be replaced with Biaerial into Hipchick.
Don't forget to watch next week's concluding video on sIFR as we share some important tuning tips.
Thanks for watching.